Hey, Pip's Thrill here. This will be my writer for worker, a pretty medium box. And the one thing that I really liked about this box, it's totally based on repositories and Azure DevOps, so cloud computing. Anyways, seeing the Nmap, we have 80 ISR running and 3690 SVN server. So SVN is basically a version controlling software just like Git. And we can use the SVN binary to get information and export and stuff like that on SVN protocol for this IP, like here. And we see there are 5 revisions and a username, Nathan, the author. This 5 revisions means there are 5 commits, you can say, and we can get each and every one, and let's see if we can find anything useful there. So for that, we can use the checkout command, checkr, then the reason we want to see, and again, the SVN protocol for that IP. So looks like a host and some kind of simple website with CSS, JavaScript, and HTML, nothing too complex. And let me just add it to the host entry. So I added worker.htb and dimension.worker.htb, and doesn't look like anything that stands out. We can check out the directory, but it won't be anything. So seeing the revision 2, we see a deploy.ps1. So it's a PowerShell script, and seeing the name deploy, it should deploy the site, and it has a username and password. So that's the vulnerability that they had. So yeah, this is basically deploying the website. In the website, we can see there is this HTML and stuff I talked about, nothing too interesting there. Let's check out the third revision and let's see if there is anything there. So looks like they modified the deploy.ps1 in this revision, and if we see, it says in note that there is no password there. So there is that. The fourth revision, we see D deploy.ps1, so they deleted it. As you can see, I cannot read it because they just deleted it. And the last revision, the fifth revision, has move.txt, and if we read it, it will tell a new host file, new subdomain with that we can include in the host file. So DevOps, so it seems like a cloud computing thing with Azure DevOps. And of course, I will need the deploy.ps1 credentials as well. So as you can see there, we added the deploy.ps1 moving to the second revision, and we will use those credentials shortly. So let's check out the simple 80 port worker.htb, a pretty standard ISS default page. So aspx would work on ISS, we'll see. The dimension.worker.htb, it's a simple HTML5 template. So there are just tabs and stuff there. Here in the work tab, we can see there are different subdomains as well. We'll get to that later. And there are just templates as well, but we'll see about that later. Next, the DevOps. So here it will ask us for credentials, and we can provide the same thing, the same credentials from we found from that PSON file. And let's see. So this right here is Azure DevOps. It kind of looks like Git or GitLab. And let's say we are this user and worker is the domain name for this Windows domain structure or domain forest, you can say. So yeah, this is a project. Let's see if we can get to anything. Let's see what does it have. As you can tell, this site is very slow. I don't know why this Azure DevOps whole thing is really slow on this box and people hated it. So yeah, I will fast forward most of the things here. And yeah, so we can basically look around and we see this spectral in the repository files. And I'm thinking we can have the other ones as well, the alpha, lens, everything. Maybe if we click the arrow, which I'll do in a second. So here are the files for the spectral website, the subdomain, this one. And yeah, so I guess we can add any file here. And as I said earlier, the aspx will help. So yeah, these are all the, we can just select anyone and upload a file there. And yeah, basically we will upload a aspx webshell, and that will give us command execution. So there is just one commit by the user themselves, and it doesn't look like anything. We can create our own branch and work with that, then we can pull it into the main branch, can just name it anything. So you will see this work field or something. You can just put any number there. It will be there. We will have to fill it every time you see it. Something about DevOps. I don't know, really. And yeah, so now we created our own branch and we can just add any file to it. And yes, let's find a aspx webshell online and we can just upload it. Searching for aspx webshell, we find like three of GitHub repositories, and I use the second one, as you will see why. This has very many features and it's better than just a normal river shell. As you will see that we don't really need a river shell right now. So anyways, I used wget on the raw format and we'll just upload this shell.aspx. And yeah, let's try that. You can write any comment and again, any work items. I don't know what that is, but it needs to be filled, otherwise it will error out or something. So we have our file here, and this isn't the master branch, so this won't be deployed. But we can pull our branch and merge it to the master branch, and that will deploy it to the website itself, thus getting us code execution, basically executing that aspx. As you can tell, it is very slow. And finally, when we get there, just enter any description, title, or anything, work items. And yes, this is our aspx shell that will be added, hopefully. And let's see what happens. So while it is loading, I can put the spectral.worker.stb in the host file so we can access it. And yeah, because we added it to the spectral repository, it will be in the spectral website. We can use any other website. This is mainly because the author knew there will be many people doing it simultaneously. So they had more than one repository that you can add to. So here we can approve this because we are the ones who created master branch and this branch as well. So it doesn't really matter. And it asks for the credentials again. You can just put them. So here, when we approve it, it does say no work items linked and it doesn't let us complete it. The first time I did this, I was very confused, and if I try to do complete, it won't let me tick this and I won't be able to complete the merge. The reason why, we have to add a work item here, and again, just type any number, it doesn't really matter, it just wants it. And yeah, after doing this, we will be able to merge it to the master branch and we won't delete this branch itself because we might need to change something, so it's better to just have it. So after quite a while it will get deployed. As you can see here, it was 404 and after quite a while it was deployed. And yeah, this is our web shell and we can just execute any command. Who am I will give us the IIS server, the user running the IIS server, and basically it's a low user, we don't really have anything. But seeing here, we have a W drive as well. And it basically has this repository of SVN that we got. And looking into it, there is a password file in the conf folder. And also some configurations we can look at, but nothing too interesting. Like right here, it's nothing really too interesting. So this password file, if I do view page source, we can look at it better, has some kind of usernames and passwords. So what we can do is brute force them. So I will just copy it into a word list and then we will separate them, users and password, and then we will see where we can brute force it. So first off, we can see I have the word list here, and let me check if the 5985 Windows Remote Management or WinRM service is open. And looks like, yeah, it is open. So we can just brute force the WinRM service using grep.exec. But first we'll have to separate this one word list into two files, users and passwords. So for that, I used awk with field separator equals. So the first argument, the first part will be usernames and the second part will be passwords. Because we don't need this space, so I included it as well in the field separator. And I'll just redirect them both to users and passwords file. Mm, Now that we have both users and passes, we can track our web exec on the VNR. So for seeing the syntax, we will of course see the help page for that. For that, we will just type tech help, and it will give us the syntax. So first off, we will need this tech u and tech p for username and password files. There is this no brute force option, which will only try the corresponding passwords to the users in the word list. So as you can see, each user has their own corresponding password. So we don't want this password to try on that user. That will just waste our time. So we'll use that option as well. So first off, tech u for users files, and tech p will be the passes files that we created, and the IP, of course. And of course, I forgot to mention the no brute force option. So let's see, it will take a bit more time because it is WinRM and brute forcing does really take time. So we'll see what happens. After quite a while, it found this username and password. I was worried it will be error out or something because of this non-domain. It's actually worker as we saw earlier, but it doesn't really matter. So let me just save it into a create file and we can just remove these users and passes, doesn't really matter. And now we can use the WinRM to log in into WinRM using this user and get the users.txt file. So of course the syntax tech u is the username, tech p is the password, and tech I will be the IP address for WinRM. So we get in as this user, and now we can grab the user.txt file, look at it in the desktop for this user, and then we can look for privilege escalation. So for that, now we have these other credentials for this user. We can try them with DevOps and see if anything changed. So let's just try that. So there is this sign in as option to sign in as another user on this domain, I guess. And we can just use the credentials we found for the user. Let's see, because the path was different, so it messed up. And we can just go to the root path and it will redirect us back. Let me just change the theme to black, or I will just go blind. right, so we have another project. And seeing this project, we will see this is developed in ASP.NET. And yeah, we can just enumerate around, see what kind of project this is. So here, listing the files, we see a build.ps1. This is a hint. The file itself doesn't matter, but build means we can build it, of course. And this is a ps1 file, so it can be used for building the whole project. So this is a hint that Azure DevOps can build this whole project. And basically what we'll do is change the, you can say the compiler's command to build this whole project. And that will give us command execution as administrator, as we'll see later. So for doing that, we go to pipelines and then builds, and we can create a new build here. So we can just select the Azure repository. It will ask again for the credentials. And after giving that, it will list the repositories we have, and we can select any one of them. We just have this one, so we'll just select that. And we have this ASP.NET pipeline, so let's just select that. Now this YAML file, it contains this pool thing, which is mostly used for when you have to compile it on many servers. We don't really need that, it will just error out. This script thing, this executes the whole command that we need to compile the whole project, but we can change it. So let's just add our user to the administrators group. And this command will be executed as the administrator because most of the compiled commands do actually need elevated privileges. And yeah, let's see if this works. We'll just create a new branch and call it anything. Doesn't really matter. And let's see what happens. So after quite a while, it says we succeeded and we can try logging in again as the user via WinRM. And we will do /all and we will see if we are in the administrators group or not. So we are in the entity authority group, so we can execute any command to anything on the system. We are the administrator now. So we can just go to the administrator's desktop and grab the root.txt flag. and there is that root flag. So there was this mission, we could have just typed the root flag from that build script, but that would have worked as well. But if we want a shell, we will have to do this. So yeah, I'll see you all next time.